India who have assembled today for this press conference. People who gave their life up so that the dream called Telangana could come to a fruition. Their families, if you engage with them, you will find that they are heartbroken. That a Telangana which was to be resilient in the iconic city of Hyderabad found itself submerged, mourned the death of 80 citizens, saw 35,000 families affected, all because of the corrupt alliance, the corrupt collaboration of convenience between MIM and DRS. Today, as we speak to you, one also would like to reflect on the fact that the charge sheet that was presented on behalf of the people of Hyderabad against the ruling family of Telangana and the convenient support they received from the MIM. The question that needs to be asked is this: is it possible that 75,000 illegal encroachments thrive in the city without the collaboration between MIM and DRS? Is it possible that today as we speak, the final memorandum which seeks to engage with the Ministry of Home Affairs for assessment of damages in this great city has not been submitted by the state government? It is to also be said that while families were left to fend for themselves and struggle during the deluge, the state government and the present incumbent within the GHMC did not even undertake any activity under Mission Indradhanush 2 so that children of the poorest of the poor families can be vaccinated. The future of Hyderabad depends on the conscientious choice which will be made by the voters in support of the Bharatiya Janata Party. Be it in the by-election in Dubaka or yesterday, the use of police force against BJP workers, it is an indication of the loss of popular support of the ruling government in the state. Through you, I would like to appeal to the people of this great city. Look at what the corrupt collaboration of MIM and TRS has to offer. They scale down the budget of GMS and promise PBs worth thousands of crores. They rehash a docket of false promises and hope to entice the poor again. And one of the most scathing allegations against this corrupt collaboration of convenience between TRS and MIM is when local and national media have aired clips of illegal immigrants thanking the TRS leadership and MIM combined of enlisting them in the voter list. A conscientious state government which has even a modicum of respect for the rule of law, would have undertaken an investigation to ensure that Rohingya Muslims are not illicitly added to the voter list. The fact that a local TV channel has openly displayed gratitude by illegal immigrants to both the Chief Minister of Telangana and MIM is a scathing certification that this corrupt alliance between MIM and the Chief Minister and his family seeks to bleed the coffers of the state and this great city, seeks to depend on illegal immigrants for their political gain. The Bharatiya Janata Party promises this iconic city clean, transparent governance, a governance model as has been espoused by our esteemed Prime Minister, underlined by the ethos of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. I now leave the floor open for questions. If you can, ma'am, just indicate your name and your publication, will be of great help.
You said about the Rohingyas, there was a question from the MIM. If there were truly Rohingya settled in the city, why did Amit Shah not take any action?
Madam, as you are aware,
If there are such Rohingyas, why doesn't the BJP produce a list?
Today, in my opening statement, I have elucidated about a local TV channel. I would like to add news made available by a national TV channel of MIM leaders using their own letterheads to have illegal Bangladeshi immigrants enrolled in the voter list. Given that law and order is a state issue, as I have said, a conscientious government which is dedicated to the rule of law should have immediately begun investigations on the basis of these two terrible, scathing affirmations of the use of illegal immigrants for political gain by the MIM and the TRS. The fact that the state government has not undertaken any stern action against MIM leaders, as has been indicated by the media itself, is a testimony to their corrupt collaboration.
Ma'am, there is another question. Sorry, if I could ask one more.
Please, ma'am.
The MIM says, why talk about Rohingyas and illegal immigrants now? Why doesn't the BJP talk about development? And KTR says that if there is a surgical strike, why can't the government talk about surgical strike on the ineffective economy? If not, the people are going to do a surgical strike on the ineffective government. What is
your
reaction?
I think, madam, two answers is what you are hoping to get from me. The Bharatiya Janata Party has taken a consistent stand in parliament and within our organization against illegal immigrants. We have consistently maintained a position that we need to protect the rights of every Indian citizen, the rights of institutions and administrations to ensure that the taxpayers' money goes to the deserving Indian who is a part of this great land. For the MIM or the TRS in an unholy alliance to espouse the cause of illegal immigrants tells you what their political identity thrives on. To say that the Bharatiya Janata Party has just brought up the issue of illegal immigrants, madam, would be to shy away from the truth that the Bharatiya Janata Party has consistently maintained
that this great land of ours rightfully belongs to every Indian citizen, whereby we need to ensure that the rights of Indian citizens are protected against illegal immigrants. Hence the fact that the TRS and the MIM will not stand by the average Indian, but choose to stand by illegal immigrants so that they can politically gain, is shameful. As far as the TRS's statement that surgical strike be ensured on issues such as economy, as the Minister of Textiles, I can proudly say that it has been my distinct privilege to ensure that under the leadership of the Honorable Prime Minister, Korean investment comes to the state to the tune of 920 crores. Under the National Technical Textiles Mission, which was announced in this year's budget, a 1,000 crore capacity production of technical textiles is being set up in Telangana. Why only the entire state? If you look at this great city of Hyderabad, under the Pradhan Mantri's Kaushal Vikas Yojana, 63,000 youngsters have been skill trained. Over 10,000 have already received their placements. What is disabilitating is that under the Sankalp Yojana, this Yojana which actually supports livelihood program, the state government is yet to submit its detailed DPR to the government of India. On one hand, you deny poor children vaccination. On the other hand, you deny an opportunity to the youngsters in this state to benefit from livelihood programs. And also, madam, an informed journalist like you knows that the Telangana government is also shying away from programs such as Ayushman Bharat, so that the poorest of the poor that is needed to be helped from over 1,300 illnesses with a yearly cover of 5 lakhs is being denied to the people of Telangana and especially Hyderabad only because the TRS wants to politically gain. Like I said, and I reiterate, madam, when I speak of the corrupt connivance and collaboration with MIM and TRS, tell me, madam, is it possible for 75,000 illegal encroachments only in one city if these two political parties had not joined hands?
Ma'am, this is sounded from Times Now.
Yes.
Your leader has said a controversial statement that surgical strike will be, you know, conducted in the old city. And after that, massive criticism erupted from the MIM and also from the TRS party. TRS leader KTR has said that surgical strike on the old city, and even MIM chief Asaduddin Owaisi said that do the surgical strike on the PLA, which is sitting inside the Indian territory, and why surgical strike on the old city?
Even would you not want to espouse the cause of striking against corruption? Would you not want to espouse the cause of striking against despondency because of lack of development? Why is it that tactically the old city has been denied the fruits of development and modernity? Is the intention of the MIM and the TRS combined to deliberately keep the electorate devoid of the fruits of development so that they can be politically exploited in elections? Why is it that these two parties combined deny the old city the fruits of modern development is my charge. Can I please, sir, have an understanding of your publication and your name? And if you could come here. Yes.
This is Srinivas Reddy from Deccan Chronicle.
Yes.
Yeah. Why not the BJP was raised about the Rohingyas and the Pakistanis? The Sanjay was said it's surgical strike. But why don't you, central government was taking action against illegal immigrants in Hyderabad and also Telangana?
Like I have reiterated to the lady journalist, sir, when I began my statement, one, there is a very, very decisive charge by the media itself
that the MIM and the TRS combined are ensuring that illegal immigrants find place in the voter list. Law and order being a state issue, you are aware of it. Why is it that if the TRS has not joined forces with MIM, has it not taken decisive action against MIM leaders who have been charged no less by the media itself of misusing their political office to have illegal immigrants enlisted in the voter list? This one charge is indication enough that the TRS and the MIM together want to ensure that illegal immigrants have a right on this iconic city, and not the citizens of our country, and not the families of Hyderabad city, who for years have also struggled to bring to fruition the statehood of Telangana. It is the people of this country and this great state who gave up their lives so that this state could find its own place in the destiny of India. Instead of honoring that sacrifice, MIM and TRS chooses to stand with illegal immigrants. That is an affront to the agitation for bringing forth the state of Telangana.
Madam, इससे पहले जो सवाल पूछा गया उसका जवाब पूरा शायद नहीं आया. असदुद्दीन ओवैसी ने कहा है कि 970 किलो वर्ग किलोमीटर स्क्वायर किलोमीटर एरिया पे जो है वो चाइनीज आर्मी ने ऑलरेडी कब्जा कर रखा है, वहां क्यों नहीं एक्शन होता, वहां क्यों नहीं बात होती? तो क्या ये बात इसमें कितनी सत्यता है कि 970 किलोमीटर एरिया में चीन ने कब्जा कर रखा है, और क्या उस सिलसिले में गवर्नमेंट की पॉलिसी लेवल पे क्या कुछ इस तरह का आप कुछ रोशनी डाल पाएंगी?
मैं इतना ही कहना चाहूंगी कि जब उनके पास हैदराबाद की नाकामियों का जवाब ना हो तो निश्चित रूप से वो इस प्रकार का प्रश्न प्रस्तुत करेंगे, ये जानते हुए कि भारत की सरहद पर भारत की फौज इतना दम रखती है कि दुश्मन देशों को वो बराबर हिंदुस्तान की ओर से जवाब दे सके. आज जो मैंने आपसे प्रश्न इस पूरी प्रश्नावली और इस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस के माध्यम से रखा वो ये कि एक तरफ हमारे देश की सरहद पर हमारी फौज लड़ रही है ताकि दुश्मन देश हमारे देश को कोई हानि ना पहुंचाए, दूसरी ओर इस शहर में, ऐतिहासिक शहर में, एमआईएम के अपने पॉलिटिकल नेता और वर्कर्स इलीगल इमिग्रेंट्स को वोटर लिस्ट में जगह दे रहे हैं. अंदर से जो घात हिंदुस्तान का वो कर रहे हैं उसका जवाब हिंदुस्तान की आवाम को, हैदराबाद की आवाम को उन्हें देना पड़ेगा. दूसरी बात जो मैंने कही कि आपने 35,000 परिवारों को डेल्यूज के वक्त संघर्ष के लिए अकेला छोड़ दिया, 80 लोग मर गए और अब तक प्रदेश की सरकार ने अपना फाइनल मेमोरेंडम नहीं दिया. क्या इस प्रदेश में और विशेषतः इस शहर में यह संभव है कि डेल्यूज का एक बहुत बड़ा कारण है इलीगल इंक्रोचमेंट? वो 75,000 इलीगल इंक्रोचमेंट बिना एमआईएम और टीआरएस की जुगलबंदी के क्या यह संभव था? तो आज अगर शहर को आपको विकास के पथ पर डालना है तो आपको सुनिश्चित करना होगा कि क्या यह इस शहर के साथ नाइंसाफी नहीं कि गरीब बच्चों का टीकाकरण ना हो, उसकी कोई एक्टिविटी अंडरटेक नहीं होती? क्या इस शहर के नौजवानों के साथ यह नाइंसाफी नहीं कि टीआरएस के उनके मित्र संकल्प कार्यक्रम के लिए अपना डिटेल प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट तक नहीं देते? तो मैंने जो आज अपने इस पूरे वक्तव्य में कहा दोबारा दोहराती हूं, एक कन्वीनियंट करप्ट कोलैबोरेशन है एमआईएम और टीआरएस के मध्य में. हैदराबाद की जनता उस कन्वीनियंट करप्ट कोलैबोरेशन को समझती है और इसीलिए हम इस बात का यहां पर विश्वास व्यक्त कर रहे हैं कि हैदराबाद की जनता इस चुनाव में अपना आशीर्वाद भाजपा को देगी.
मैडम, दिस इज लोकेश फ्रॉम न्यूज एक्स एंड केटीआर, द वर्किंग प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ टीआरएस हैज बीन रिपीटेडली सेइंग दैट देयर इज नो वायलेंस of communalization or anything for last 7 years, but BJP is trying to communalize the politics, and Ovaisi has challenged you openly to show 1000 names of illegal Rohingyas or anybody.
I am appealing to you again, sir. Look at the media reports and especially the audiovisual reports given by a national channel and a local channel. On the local channel, a Rohingya Muslim is openly declaring gratitude for enrolling him in the voter list, and he expresses his gratitude not only to MIM, he expresses it to the MIM and the CM of Telangana. in the national channel, the media itself has brought to fore how MIM political leaders on their letterheads are ensuring that illegal Bangladeshi immigrants also find a mention in the voter list. You tell me, sir, law and order being a state issue, would a conscientious government not start an investigation? Why is it that the TRS kept quiet on it? Because they seek to politically gain from their alliance from the MIM and politically gain by using illegal immigrants and having them illicitly brought to the voter list. Anybody who wants to ensure that the dream that we had for Telangana is fulfilled would have made sure that the rights of the citizens of Hyderabad and Telangana are protected and not the rights of illegal immigrants.
Ma'am, this is Anil from Republic TV.
Yes.
AIMIM Chief Asaduddin Owaisi has also given out a statement in that regard and said that BJP is violating the rule of love jihad. And what do you have to
violating
say?
Violating the rule of?
Section 14.
If you read the tenets and the pillars on which the Indian Constitution stands, it disallows fraudulent and illegal coercive action against a woman. If a state government takes within the ambit of the Constitution steps to ensure that women are not criminally and fraudulently coerced into a relationship, should the right and the protection of that woman not be supported by Indians across the country, illegal, irrespective of our political ideology? When the intent of the state within, I said repeatedly, under the ambit of the Constitution is to ensure that fraudulent and criminal coercion is dissuaded so that the rights of women is protected, my appeal is that we look at this issue from that perspective.
But then he says that BJP is violating the law and so what do you have
to... Does the law provide for women to be fraudulently exposed? Does the law provide for women to be fraudulently and criminally coerced? It does not. Sir, I am repeating as I said in the beginning. The final memorandum from the state government of Telangana to MHA for the assessment has not even been submitted by them. If they don't submit the proposal, the final memorandum. However, the Bharatiya Janata Party led NDA government at the center through the MHA by the 3rd of November has released an advance of 224 crores. The Telangana government cannot deny it.
Ma'am, last question. Just,
yes.
This, ma'am, here, Swami.
Yes.
Lalu, RJD chief, Lalu speaks to BJP MLA, Lalan Paswan, and he asked him to be, you know, absent for the speaker elections, and he also offers him ministerial berth. What would you like to say, ma'am, on this? And,
I was hoping to concentrate only on the GHMC. You would like me to answer on from China onwards to Bihar. I'm happy for that privilege to be given to me. The election has been decidedly lost by the RJD. The fact that they would like to explore illicit methods to want to be in power is the very reason why the people of Bihar rejected them. Bihar has reasserted its belief of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. And as a Bharatiya Janata Party Karyakarta, I express my public gratitude to the citizens of Bihar.
Ma'am.
Thank you.
Ma'am.
क्या मुझे इस बात को एंडोर्स करना चाहिए, समर्थन करना चाहिए कि करप्शन के खिलाफ एक्शन हो? हाँ, मैं निश्चित रूप से करप्शन के खिलाफ एक्शन हो इसकी पक्षधर हूँ. क्या मेरा ये पक्ष होना चाहिए कि ओल्ड सिटी में विकास हो?
हां मैं इस बात की पूरी तरह से पक्षधर हूं कि ओल्ड सिटी में विकास हो, विशेषतः जब विकास से वंचित ओल्ड सिटी को इसलिए लिखा गया है ताकि एमआईएम के कार्यकर्ता वहां के लोगों का पॉलिटिकल फायदा उठा सके। क्या मैं इस बात की पक्षधर हूं कि जीएचएमसी में एक ट्रांसपेरेंट गवर्नेंस मॉडल प्रतिस्थापित होना चाहिए? बिल्कुल मैं उसकी पक्षधर हूं और इसीलिए जनता से अपील करती हूं कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी को अपना समर्थन, अपना आशीर्वाद और अपना वोट वो दे।
मैम लास्ट क्वेश्चन,
धन्यवाद।
देयर इज वन क्वेश्चन, यू आर अलेगिंग दैट असदुद्दीन ओवैसी हैड लिंक्स विद द टेररिस्ट एंड योर पार्टी पीपल आर अलेगिंग दैट, व्हाई डोंट यू अरेस्ट असदुद्दीन ओवैसी लाइक वरवर राव अरेस्टेड इन द हैदराबाद सिटी?
आई वुड लाइक टू रीअफर्म एंड रीअसर्ट सर, एज आई हैव सेड इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ दिस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस, द टू प्रेस रिपोर्ट्स दैट आई हैव हियर brought to your notice, one by the national press and another by a local channel, are a scathing testimony to the collaboration between the MIM and the TRS with regards to ensuring that illegal immigrants find a place in the voter list. State being in charge of law and order, why is it that TRS has not taken action against such media reports after they have come to the fore in the interest of the citizens of Hyderabad? That again I reiterate is a certification that the unholy alliance between MIM and TRS is so that the coffers of Telangana and especially the iconic city Hyderabad can be bled. Thank you.
Subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button. Click the bell button and enjoy the latest uploads from our channel.